Tonight on Live in Your Lounge, with a live studio audience, Alec Randles and Moondog.
Welcome, welcome everyone to Live in Your Lounge. Some of you are watching from your lounges at home, and others of you are here in our live studio audience. Please, audience, make yourselves welcome and known to us with a great round of applause. You guys sound like a fantastic audience. Welcome, welcome to the Canberra Initiative, supporting artists and entertaining all of us throughout COVID-19. Tonight, the entertainment is supplied by Alec Randles and Moondog. It is going to be a fantastic evening. My name is Lexi, but I like to call myself Catgirl Lexi to Batman Ryan Banks, my co-host and partner in music promotion, who is out there in amongst our audience. Hello, Batman Banksy.
Good evening, Lexi. How are we?
Very well, and all the better for having you as my co-host and sidekick.
Oh, stop it, you bloody flirt. Man, are we looking forward to a good show this evening. A double whammy of fantastic musical prowess, shall I say. Live studio audience, are you looking forward to tonight's show? I think that is a resounding yes. How good is this? Live music, live audience, live streaming, and the whole shebang. You got Lexi in the lounge as well. We've got a couple of interviews coming your way. And of course, if anyone at home is watching and wants to be a part of tomorrow's live studio audience, Lexi, I believe there is a competition they can enter. Is that correct?
That's right. Accurate as always, Banksy. It is such a joy, I agree with you, to have our live studio audience. So you glorious streamers out there, if you would like to join us, then our competition giveaway is for 2 free tickets to join us tomorrow night. All you need to do is jump onto Facebook or Instagram, find the competition post, and the way to go into the running this evening is really, really fantastic. Put up a gift which represents what your week was like. I have a feeling that the competition tonight is going to be extremely humorous and quite enjoyable for us to randomly select the winner, who I will announce at the very, very end of the evening. So why don't we get the evening started? You gorgeous live studio audience there and our wonderful stream audience, please put your hands together and welcome to the Live in Your Lounge stage, our first act for the evening. It is Alec Randles.
Confidence, where's the mind of a fool? He's scared and he knows it. Nah, dude, so you see, it's so transparent what he's trying to do. Hide, hide away, cause he's petrified. Born of this nature, I'm gonna love her till I kill her. That's why this fool needs to throw this off. He's gotta get them kicks before his term is up. And I said this, I don't know him, don't really claim to do. He's a wiser man the world, and we'll see him through. He's a psychopath, power in his hand. He'll be the only one I know, lead the weak, I say. Petrified.
lost control of art, and now it's obsolete. I said it, this music rights to pacify, and for this I'm petrified. It was a language once that kept them all at bay. But you failed, see now we can't mobilize. Changing, man, it's a different time and place, but the fool prevails, and the sickness lives large in him. I am paranoid, will not overcome. Oh, paranoid, I'm all petrified. And I said this, I don't know her, don't really claim to do. She my lover, world, and we'll see her through. She's an observer, yeah. Power in her heart, she'll be the only one I know. Lead the weak, I say. Said, I say. Petrified, I say this. Petrified, I know it. Petrified, I say. Did you hear? You're so petrified, you're so petrified. Petrified, you're so petrified, I say. Petrified with your hands in a golden plane. Petrified, you're so petrified.
Thank you. Alright, so that was a brand new song. That's the first time we've played that song live, so hope you all at home and everyone here in the audience enjoyed that one. It's a song called Petrified, and we're working towards releasing an EP with that tune on it, but we honestly don't know when we're going to finish it. So this is an old song. This is one of the first ones we played together. This is a tune called Awake. Enjoy.
Street.
Thank you so much. So I don't know if you guys saw it, but we played live in your lounge in late June as a band. We both play in a band called Copacetic, based here in Canberra. We play a lot of roots and reggae music and a bit of folk music. And one of the covers we like to play is a song called Golden Brown. And we thought, you know what, let's just give this a crack, see if we can play it tonight as a duo. So see what we can do. Thank you. Thanks so much. It sure is different to the last time we played here. There was no audience. So it's probably one of the last gigs I played as well. Thank you. doing that little thing called jamming. All right, we're going to take a little break. Be back in a couple of minutes. Thanks so much. Cheers.
Are you enjoying Live in Your Lounge? Head to liveinyourlounge.com, hit donate, and support your artists.
Alec Randles there, warming us up on this real shocker of a Canberra winter night. I shall be well warmed up mentally now that I'm joined by Moondog, Jeremy of Moondog, here on the lounge. Hello, welcome.
Hello, Lexi.
Thank you
very much for having me.
No, it's our pleasure. Thank you for joining us here at Live in Your Lounge and becoming a permanent family member of Live in Your Lounge.
Well, feeling that, I like that.
Now, I was doing some research on you and I found on your website a phenomenal quote. I've got to read this out. The blues are the roots and other musics are the fruits. It's better keeping the roots alive because it means better fruits from now on. A Willie Dixon quote, a quite remarkable quote. Tell us what, why is that on your website?
That quote's always had a lot to do with my musical journey. I started with listening to like hip hop and rap when I was a kid. And when I was about 18, I dove into the world of the blues. And the first records that I'd found were belonged to my mum, and it was Howlin' Wolf, Muddy Waters. These were the penultimate Chicago blues artists of the 50s and 60s. And the guy who quoted that was Willie Dixon, who was a bass player and also a songwriter. He wrote many of the big hits for a lot of those artists, including like Hoochie Coochie Man, Spoonful, many songs that were also covered by so many big blues artists down the line, including the British explosion that happened straight after that 50s Chicago era. So, yeah, I think like it's a very deep quote for me because it's related to where music comes from, but it also, I think it's related to modern music and in terms of the fact that blues is a music that's been recorded a lot and recording devices have only been around for, you know, 100 odd years or so. So it's a very significant part of that musical and cultural journey. And the blues is the roots of so many types of music. Its elements are in everything.
Yeah, phenomenal. And I can hear in that some kind of like international influence. And I see that you travel a huge amount. Music and gigs always take musos everywhere. But you really pre-COVID had like a jam-packed schedule, I have to say.
Yes.
So how has this time been? I can only imagine you felt a little bound and a little stuck.
It's been very challenging. It's been quite tough. In ways, in the beginning, it was kind of a relief in a way that I kind of just could just pull the reins up and just have some time for myself, and using the time as well to create new stuff, which is great as well. But it's also I've had to face the reality that you know, travel might not be the same anymore, and that's been a huge part of who I am, you know. And so yeah, it's tough. I've been finding it tough.
Yeah, no, of course. And you make a good point that things may not actually return totally to the way that they were before. Something that seems to be something in your past and way things were before is that I saw you were a veteran of the WA hip-hop scene.
Yeah.
So what's that backstory?
Yeah, so like I said, my influence before the blues was mainly rap and hip-hop. So sort of in my teens, I got into that. I got into writing raps, I got into breakdancing, and you know, hip-hop is a culture with, you know, a lot of elements, breakdancing, rap, DJing, and graffiti art as well. And also, you know, everything else, skating and, you know, fashion, stuff like that. Now it's influenced the world, but that's what I was into. And then so early on when I moved to WA, I got into a crew called the Delta Force, young lads just writing raps, creating beats, doing live shows, which was great. I sort of gravitated more towards singing in the blues as I got older, and a lot of the groups that I ended up sort of working with were like, oh, you can sing, so we got to get you to sing the hook. And so that's why I became a hook man. And
it's often the way, right? Right? Someone else will see, hey, you've got a strength there.
Yeah.
You do that for us.
Yeah, well, I think, you know, a lot of hip-hop artists like to sample things, but if they don't have to sample, then they can kind of like tell you how to do it, or you can figure it out. And that's a plus, I guess.
Yeah, great.
I don't mind being utilised in that sense.
Tell me, are you still doing any dancing? Are you still doing any breakdancing?
Not much at all, no.
So we won't see you busting out any moves tonight?
No.
Oh, man. I'll see if I can convince you otherwise.
Oh, yeah, maybe.
Hey, there seems to be some light at the end of the tunnel, though, or a little bit of an opening up, because you've got a live gig next week.
Yeah?
Is the calendar starting to shift a little bit and fill up a tiny bit?
Slowly, yeah. There's I'm getting approached a bit more. I mean, I haven't been that proactive, but I mean, I think I've been doing it for a while, and I think my tactic now is for people to approach me. So, and I'm getting people asking about gigs more and more. So, you know, there's venues like the Old Canberra Inn that started doing theirs early on. Love that place. Got to give a shout out to all that crew. The CBS has been really good to me. The Canberra Blues Society, I had a gig with them, so they'll continue doing stuff. Next week, I'm at the Boardwalk in Belconnen.
Great.
And I've never played there before, but it's a fabulous venue, and I'm looking forward to it. And the owners are really nice, and they're just trying to do something, you know, trying to make some stuff happen.
Yeah, yeah. Sold out though, right? So
yeah.
Yeah. So no, is it going to be streamed or no? Just a purely live one.
Yeah, I don't know. Someone might pull a phone out or something like that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Great.
Not like this, anyway. This is amazing.
Oh well, it's amazing for us to have you. So thank you so much for coming and joining us here at Live in Your Lounge.
Thank you so much.
Particularly as your next gig is sold out, so it means that if anyone wanted to go along to that gig, then what's great is this stream will stay up online. So we'll have Jeremy play in the second half of this evening. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see. Maybe there'll be some dance moves, right? Maybe we can talk about that.
A little flip, maybe.
We'll see. Just a little flip. Can't wait. Thank you, again for joining us. So, you talkative, chatty live studio audience out there, I know you are so excited for the music and for the music only. So, would you please put those glasses down, put the cheese platter down, and give a round of applause? Welcome back to the stage. It is him here for his second set. A big, big round of applause. Applause for Alec Randles.
Love is the most high. Yeah. far as my eyes can see. Oh, let it rain, let it rain, let it fall so hard. Oh, my love is so thirsty, wanna taste your ecstasy. See now, there's a storm coming overhead. Yeah, don't know if I want to sink or swim, here's what I dread. But maybe one time when your loving's all the way, let it pound out over these levees, I just want to play. See now, I'm looking up while the rain is falling down. Oh, now wash away from my love and somehow I said and I let it go and let it come back so right. Oh, I wanna hear it all my time. I say, see it come again, oh, till unfortunately we fall. Yes, they give me love once, till I'm loving all in all. Yes, it come again until unfortunately we rise. Love is the most high.
Thank you. This is this next song is one of my older originals. It's a song some people who come watch my gigs, not many, three or four of you. this is my song called These Days. Hope you enjoy. Thank you. Cheers. That is a song called These Days. Now, this is the most enjoyable part of a show for me, changing tuning. Going down to a tuning called Dadgad, which is a popular tuning for Celtic fingerstyle guitar. But we're not doing any of that. We're going to play two songs for you that we wrote while we were playing a tour in New Zealand back in January, back in the good times. And we really enjoyed playing these songs live. The first one's a song called Peace of Mind, and the second one's a song called Peter. We'd also like this opportunity to thank all the crew at Live in Your Lounge, Event AV Services for the sound, lighting, and everything. Really appreciate it. And we'd also like to take the time to do a quick shout out. We're in the street theater earlier today doing a live video recording with Vacant Room Records, a new group coming up in Canberra. If you're into your kind of local live music, definitely check those guys out. All right. It's a song called Peace of Mind. They present themselves, babe, quicker than you find these dreams. Careers, houses, competition, fiends, but the iron mind just makes some time. I can tell by the way that she walks, her years are slowing down somehow. Yeah, she got it all figured out. Peace of mind.
my darkest of days, I was made. She said, man, you know I believe in you, and that's all you need. Well, see now, girl, I'm a vagabond, mind to mind and a heart to heart. And I wanted to tell you that all these years I believe. In my hands, better off you're gone. Now I'm a vagabond, babe. Now I'm a vagabond.
Thanks so much. May I introduce Mr. James Bergoglio on the cajon? I think that was a bit of a passive-aggressive thing then. Hadn't introduced him yet. It's all right, man. All right, this is our last song for the night. Thanks so much for coming down and listening. It's an interesting place, interesting time. Yeah, this is a tune called Peter, and it's another one of our upcoming EPs. The first song we played tonight, Petrified. That one, Peace of Mind, and this one, Peter. We're hoping to release as part of an EP sometime soon.
Friend, parted like grains and the sand from the sea. But don't feel alone, she whispers to me. Close your eyes, hold your breath, and so fall to become a rolling stone, like they always sing about. Dream showed me a world through the window, vision of an old home, and it says to and fro. I've got some time, you see, but it's precious. I can't stay here, man, I just can't go for the lonely of her, those whose days are dull and afraid. I'll raise my hand to you, kind my boy. So close your eyes, hold your breath, and to be this sailor Jerry. The most powerful weapon, see, the rise.
state of mind, though I feel I'm true compassion.
Thanks so much, everyone. I'm Alec Randles. Cheers. Just James Bergoglio. And stick around for Mr. Moondog. We're really looking forward to seeing his set. Thanks so much, Live in Your Lounge. Thank you.
Everything audio,
visual,
and all technical production services, contact Event AV Services. The team at Event AV Services is still operating and still here to help with services to purchase or hire. They offer video conferencing, virtual classrooms for your students, web streaming, and they can even organize live paid subscription broadcasts of virtual concerts and performances. Event AV Services. Visit eavs.com.au.
Are you enjoying Live in Your Lounge? Head to liveinyourlounge.com, hit donate, and support your artists.
Alec Randles there, and how fantastic to have James join him on hand percussion. It was fantastic to have both of them join us a couple of months ago, and he will zip around and join me on the lounge very, very soon. So in some way, it may not be music, it'll be talking, but there is a little bit more of Alec to come. There's a bit more of Live in Your Lounge to come as well, with Moondog up soon. And then tonight is all about the Thunder. Streaming from 7:30 p.m. tomorrow, we have Thunder Fox and Thunder Goose. You can tune in on all of our usual places online, YouTube, Facebook, or our website, liveinyourlounge.com. And of course, if you fancy joining us in person, there are still a few in-person studio tickets available. If you're not already streaming on our website, then do jump onto liveinyourlounge.com, and that's where you can book those last few remaining tickets. We can only have 50 live studio audience members here, and that is so that we have an entirely COVID-safe environment here at the Mallee Pavilion at Epic. Rest assured, we will take care of you from the time that you book all the way through to the very end of the evening. There's quite a few protocols to follow, but as I say, everyone here at Live in Your Lounge will make sure that you have a fantastic time and that everyone stays entirely COVID safe. Now, for our audience, our boisterous and fantastic audience this evening, how about my partner in music promotion, Mr. Ryan Banks? How about you tell me, what's it like out there? How's it going?
Oh, it's pretty quiet, Lex, actually. I'm not sure if anyone's enjoying it. That might be a lie. What do you reckon, guys? How are you enjoying the show so far? Enjoying it a lot, I think. And how could we not? Friday night, a bit of live music. We've got the bar open as well. Round of applause for the bar. Always gets the biggest clap, I find. They got a ton of good food as well. May I please show you what I'm treating myself to this evening? If you guys here have not experienced this yet, get a load of this good stuff. Oh, where's my light? There it is. That is some chocolatey, nutty, marshmallow, donutty goodness right there. How could you say no? All that and a bit of live music. Not bad in the slightest. Our audience have been loving it. I've gone around. I've had a bit of a chin wag. Wow, that was tough to say. With a few of them. And I think we have a bit of an international audience with us today. Can our non-Australian friends with us tonight make some noise? Myself included. Woo! There we go. Obviously, they're all here on holiday. But I managed to go around and get a few comments from them. I think everyone's been enjoying it. Ben has commented saying how fantastic it is to be able to get out and enjoy live music. Wendy has come in saying the sound is so crisp and clear that we should really consider ramping it up a little bit louder. But I think the best comment for me so far tonight comes from 9-year-old Sierra, who said that the guitar sounds so cool and somehow even sounds electric. Also, Alec has a nice voice. And I do want to quickly say thank you to Sierra for that comment. She is 9 years old, but in 3 days from now, she is celebrating her 10th birthday. How about a round of applause for Sierra? Now, normally this is also part of the show that I do my best to dig up some dirt on tonight's acts just to make it a little bit juicy. But I tell you what, the phrase smooth sailor was used about 3 or 4 different times describing Alec Randles. So not much dirt to dig up, but I have been told, Lexi, that we do need an explanation from Alec in regards to how to best describe this. A year 12 moody Alec unfriending Briggsy on Facebook. If you can follow this up for me, we'd love to hear an answer and an explanation about this.
Aha. Ever the journalist, Mr. Ryan Banks, ever the investigative journalist. Now, I think I recall this unfriending moment. I am joined by Mr. Smooth Sailor himself, Alec Randles. Hello. Hello.
Hey, how you doing? Is this on?
It is. It is. It is indeed. Now, 2 months ago, as you flagged, you were here. That's when you became a member of the family, you and Briggsy. And I remember in our pre-interview, one of you brought up the unfriending. Now, and I've gotten it wrong. And then the other one said, no, don't mention that. Don't mention that. And so I said, oh, we won't. And I started making notes. And then one of you came in, like, no, Lexi, don't. I was like, oh, okay, no, fine, sorry, we won't talk about that.
Yeah.
But it's out.
Yeah.
So
monkey's out the barrel.
It is. Monkeys are everywhere.
Yeah.
All right, so tell us what happened.
I don't know what to say. James, he just wouldn't stop liking all my stuff, and so I just had to delete him. Nah, he actually deleted me. I think it was just kind of an irrelevance thing, really. And then we've started this band. I messaged him and said, I apologize and I accept your apology in advance.
Oh.
Do you want to join a band? And he said, yeah.
Great.
And the rest is history, yeah. So I forgave him.
Great. Then became highly relevant.
Yeah.
And I think all is mended after the beautiful 2 sets that you just did.
I don't know.
And the great partnership that you have. But monkey, what did you say? Monkey's out of the barrel. Yeah, everything's out. But here at Live in Your Lounge, we're
very
all
dramatic,
family members.
Yeah.
And so now now that we know the story and now that it's out, it's all good.
Yeah.
But hey, tell us, I mean, I cannot believe that it's been 2 months.
Yeah,
since,
I know, it's
since
crazy.
You were here. What have you been up to? What does it what's it feel like for you?
Just a lot of beer. No, just not much has changed really. I've just been working from home since before then, and I've only just gone back into the office now.
Mm.
We've just started jamming a bit more, which is nice. I think we talked about it last time we were here. When COVID started, we just had a breather and stopped practicing and stuff. It was quite nice because immediately before that, it was all very busy. James and I toured New Zealand, and we started as a band, the Copacetic five-piece. We started playing our first festivals and stuff, which was cool, and then it all just stopped, and we'd had a couple nights a week practicing and stuff like that up until then, so we just said, hey, let's just relax and calm down, and then I've used that time to write a couple more songs, which we played one of them tonight, Petrified.
Yeah, great. That was so brilliant.
Thank you.
We've actually been really honoured at Live in Your Lounge to get some special new gems.
Cool.
So it was great that you could add to that for us. Tell us about the New Zealand tour though. That was as you said, what did you call January? You were like back when times were good or times were normal. So tell us about the tour.
It was really cool. It was the first time I've played in the States a bit. And in some other areas, but it was the first time we kind of put together an actual tour and set up ticketing and hired a venue and stuff like that. We played 4 shows over there, and it was really cool. The first one was in Auckland. I've got some family over there, and a couple of my family rocked up, which was really nice. And we actually ended up selling out that show, which was really cool. It had about 70 people capacity. And it was a really cool experience to go to a new place to play music and just see people I've never seen before and stuff like that. It was really nice.
Great. And then even during COVID, you had, I guess it was because of that tour, you had a little international stream moment, right?
Yeah, so a venue in New Zealand, it was actually through a guy. He's a cool guy. He's in a band called, I don't know how to pronounce it, the Rhythms or something, but they play like roots and reggae music in Auckland. He just messaged me and said, hey man, would you be interested in doing a live stream for this live music venue in New Zealand, seeing as they're shutting down, we're trying to get some online stuff going. So that was a really cool experience. So just kind of, it was actually like pre-recorded. So I filmed myself, sent it to them, they mixed it and everything. And then they put it together on a 2-hour video that was played through a live stream on Facebook, which was, it was nice, it was cool.
Yeah, great. It's really special, isn't it, to have some kind of international barriers, I suppose, leapt or overcome because of COVID. So hopefully there can be a little bit more of that.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Yeah.
I'm really hoping those dudes come to Australia, actually, because it'd be really cool to tour with them.
Yeah, wicked. Thank you so much for coming back. you're in the special club, which are the you know, multiple serial, not serial offenders, but because it's a good and wonderful positive thing. brilliant to have you join us.
Thanks.
Here
again. It's really nice to come and play.
Yeah, absolutely fantastic. And you've got at least one fan out there, as we heard.
Oh yeah, thanks so much. Happy birthday. And it's my brother's birthday as well today, so happy birthday, Mr. Dollar Bill, wherever you are. Yeah.
Great, gorgeous birthdays all around. Thank you again, Alec. Thank you so very, very much. Now for us, I love it when I get to say it's only halfway. So our gorgeous studio audience and even everyone at home, let's raise our glasses and get back to the music. Welcome to the Live In Your Lounge stage. It's our second act for the evening. It is Moondog.
I'm going way away where the wind don't blow. some other man, 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 some other man is always hanging around.
Thank you very much, folks. Making me feel warm up here, even though it's freezing here in Canberra. My name is Moondog. I'm going to play a bit of blues for you in this set. This next song is about a freeway that runs from Chicago down through the south. And I've been traveling that expressway, actually, for 10 years. And it's called I-55. And if anyone's watching from America, I miss you guys. Love you guys. I would have been there, but, you know, it happens. This one's called I-55. Come on. Cover from one of my favorite artists of all time that we lost just recently, Mr. Bill Withers. Any Bill Withers fans out there? Mm-hmm.
crowd of high-class people, and then you act real rude to me. Until you use me up.
We're starting to warm up in here. I'm going to do one more tune, then we're going to go for a little break. I'm going to slow it down and do a slow blues for you. I want to take this opportunity to thank you all for coming down, and a big thanks to all the crew and cast. This is a spectacular little setup. It's not little at all, actually. It's very pro, and I'm very proud to be here. Thank you so much for doing this and making it happen. And I want to give a shout out to all the people around the world that I can't be with, all my friends in Chicago and Memphis, Mississippi, New Orleans, and all my friends in WA. We'll be together soon. Well, you told me, baby, your love for me was strong. But when I woke up this morning, half this big old round world was gone. That's all right. I know you don't love me no more, but that's all right. Every now and then I wonder who's loving you tonight. Got some other man, but that's all right. Every now and then I wonder who's loving you tonight.
Man, I just want to shout out the whole Eve's crew. All the guys here that are put on Live In Your Lounge.
This is genuinely unreal. I think it's something that we were thinking about doing, but just didn't have the capacity to do it ourselves.
The amount of people working behind the scenes is quite impressive. It is a full-on production, just like a TV show or something, you know. It's very cool.
You guys have given artists a really good platform during this time when we can't make money from touring or even reach our fan bases through live shows. So we really appreciate what you guys are doing. You put together a very high-quality, dope aesthetic for us to perform in.
And to get multiple groups of different levels of their professional career all together to create a great show a couple of times a weekend. Best thing that's happened since sliced bread.
We can't be giving you a show anytime soon. We can't be coming to a venue, to your house, whatever. We can just give you everything we have through this four-digit wall right here. So I hope you guys enjoy it. The energy's going to be just the same, and if not, something even more. So I hope you dig it. It definitely matches the caliber of what we usually do live, and we're really, really grateful for that. So thank you to the whole Eve's crew and everyone putting this together, because we're grateful to be here.
Moondog there, and we just saw a wildly talented individual here at the Live in Your Lounge studio. I think we just have to burst into spontaneous applause. I'm going to burst into spontaneous applause for the talent of Jeremy just then. Please, you guys in the studio. And we get another set. We get another set. Banksy and I were just trying to count how many instruments does Jeremy just do himself.
It's ridiculous. That man can multitask better than I can breathe and think. I think I counted, we had like an instrument on each foot.
Indeed, indeed.
We had the guitar, the harmonica, and the vocals.
Yep.
Honestly, how do you train for something like that? That makes me insanely jealous. I haven't got anywhere near as much talent as that man has in his left foot.
Well, I disagree, because that gorgeous video that we just watched then, that behind the scenes video, was made by yourself, Mr. Ryan Banks. So talent abounds here at Live in Your Lounge.
Oh, look, I'll play dumb a little bit, but yeah, I'm super talented, Lexi. What can I say? that video actually was incredibly easy for myself to produce, actually, because the amount of artists that were so keen to talk about the work that Event AV Services does here, it was just incredibly easy to capture those wonderful moments. And I think, it is worth mentioning again, Event AV Services, who produce this show week in, week out for the last 5 months, have just done a terrific, terrific job. And one of my favorite factors of this show is the level of engagement they've been able to make. And so something I always like reading, I love reading the comments that come in from our loyal viewers at home, and they're well worth a shout out. We've got a couple of repeat offenders amongst us, who we always love to see every week. Got Sandy Hammersley, hopefully I've said that right, she said great performance. The mighty Zinbin, who I think has been here for every single show.
Oh, huge shout out. So much love to Zin. I think has been there, a previous winner one time of our competitions, and indeed, I'm pretty sure Zin has watched every single stream.
She's more in tune to this show than I am, and I work on it. But yeah, she says thanks so much for putting this show on. She's also dropped in a cheeky mention that she has left her donation for this evening. So if I can talk about that. Live in the Lounge is an independently funded venture, so we absolutely could not do it without the support of the public and everyone out there, and especially our live studio audience who are here with us this evening. A huge thanks to them. I'll smash for you. Yes, you can give yourself a round of applause. I'll quickly list off the few remaining names I do have. Josh Patton is loving the sound. Nick Douglas says sounds amazing. And we got another sounds amazing from the Tipsy Scholars, who are another fantastic local band who were on the stage not too long ago, and they're doing fantastic things. Keep an eye out for the Tipsy Scholars and the stuff they've got coming up on the horizon.
Well, I must give a shout out to Jimmy, who is creating all of that fantastic sound. I've got Steve here on the lounge who does my sound, but it was even our live studio audience said that they loved it. And then to get all of those gorgeous comments, well done, Jimmy, for creating that sonic experience for us. So I don't know if I can take any more talent coming at us, but we do have another set. So gorgeous live studio audience, who I think I'm going to award you guys best live studio audience ever. Would you please put your hands together and let's enjoy the last part of this glorious, glorious Friday evening. Forget the rain, forget the winter. We are rocking it here with none other than it is Moondog.
It's going to be That joker got lucky, stole her back again. You better come on in my kitchen, cause it's going to be raining out of. Well, she's gone, no, she won't come back. I stole the last nickel out her nation's sack. You better come on in my kitchen, cause it's going to be raining out of. Everybody wants to drag her down, looking for her good friend that can't be found. You better come on in my kitchen, cause it's going to be raining out of. You better come on in my kitchen, cause it's going to be raining out of. You better come on in my kitchen, cause it's going to be raining out of. I wanna tell you a story, yes ma'am, about my girl. She's the sweetest thing I know in this world. Oh, she's fine and unique. Everything about her is so sweet, and I'm so talking about her in the neighborhood. The people all looking at you, cause you look so good. Oh, you're fine and unique. Everything about you is so sweet, and I'm so glad. Thank you.
the way she walks up and down the street. Made a dumb man talk. So fine, she's so good, she's so very good to me, and I'm so glad she's mine. Hey, thank you very much. My Chilean friends in the house. It's good to be in Canberra still with all this stuff going on. I've got a lot of family and friends here, so thank you to you guys. I started that bracket with my own version of an early blues song by a very famous blues man by the name of Robert Johnson, the guy who went to the crossroads and sold his soul to the devil so that he could play the guitar really well. And then I moved on to my version of a song by one of my favorite Chicago artists, Magic Sam, West Side Blues. Yeah, really like Magic Sam. He's a huge influence on my playing. I love his tone and the way he plays. I'm going to do a little Green Onions thing for you. Around sunrise, early in the morning, just around sunrise. You lay there rolling your big old bloodshot eye. I love the way you walk. I love the way you talk. When you hold my hand. I love you, pretty baby. You, my darling, got my eyes on you.
far you go. Don't care how long you stay. That good kind treatment will bring you home someday. Someday, baby. Can tell everybody in the neighborhood. Yes, you know you don't treat me like the way you should. You my baby, I still love you. I've got my eyes on you.
Please keep the round of applause going for Alec Randles. That was amazing. It's the first time I've got to catch him, so what a great setting to do it. What a beautiful sound you have, man. Oh, yeah. All right, I'm going to do a tune that has been around for a while. I think I wrote it my first trip to Chicago in 2009. And I'm going to dedicate this one to anyone out there in Chicagoland. And anyone who's having a bit of a beer or a drink tonight. This is a little drinking song. It's called Fix Myself a Drink. Real easy one to sing along with, especially if you're drunk. The lyrics is the easy part.
Of a time, drink so much liquor till I almost lose my mind. I don't know about y'all, I'm gonna fix myself a drink. Yeah, well, I get so drunk till I don't know how to think. Early in the morning, sunlight hurts my eyes. I got a head full of worries and a heart full of lies. I don't know about y'all. Up a drink. Well, I get so drunk till I don't know love my whiskey, crazy about my gin. Promise my baby I'd never drink again. I don't know about y'all. I'm gonna fix myself a drink, yeah. When I get so drunk till I don't know how to think, I'm gonna fix myself a drink. That's all it is. Fix myself a drink. I'm gonna fix myself a drink. Fix myself a drink. When I get so drunk till I don't know how to think, I'm gonna fix myself a drink. Let me hear you a little bit. I'm gonna fix myself a drink. I'm gonna fix myself a drink. Fix myself a drink. When I get so drunk that I don't know how to see my good time girls, swimming to see whiskey to the whole room starts to swell. I don't know about y'all, I gotta fix myself a drink. When I get so drunk till I don't know how to think, one more time, I'm gonna fix myself a drink. Fix myself a drink.
Very much. I'm going to do one more and get the hell out of here, but I want to say thanks again for everyone for coming down, and this setup is amazing. So please, if you can donate, yeah, these guys are doing amazing stuff, so it's worthy. And hopefully we get a few more live gigs around town, and we can hang out and actually get drunk and party together. That'd be cool too. All right, this is a tune from one of my other big influences in the blues, the late, great Bobby Blue Bland. It just won't let me go.
go right on living. Why? I just don't know. I really got to use my imagination to think of a good reason to keep on keeping on. Of a bad situation. Ever since the day I woke up, found you gone.
Are you enjoying Live in Your Lounge? Head to liveinyourlounge.com, hit donate, and support your artists.
The multi-talented, magnificent Moondog there, finishing off our Friday night. A massive thank you must go to Moondog and to Alec Randles and also to James for giving us such a fantastic Friday night here at Live in Your Lounge.
However, the evening is not quite done yet. There is still one very important factor that we have to put to bed.
Yes, yes, of course, of course. I nearly forgot the announcement of the winners for our ticket giveaway.
And because we are feeling especially generous, we've actually doubled the prizes. So two people will be taking home two tickets for tomorrow night's show.
That's right, Banksy. It is with great pleasure that I announce our two sets of winners. Huge congratulations goes to Honey West for her gorgeous emoji post on Instagram and to Bronwyn Dixon for her equally gorgeous and just a little bit hilarious post on Facebook. Both Honey and Bronwyn, you will join us tomorrow night for our Live in Your Lounge starting at 7:30 tomorrow night.
There we go. Double the prize for double the thunder for tomorrow night's show, which, on a rather sad note, will actually be the penultimate episode of Live in Your Lounge, which I'm very, sad to reveal right there. Live Indie Lounge has been bringing live music to the masses for the past 5 months now, giving artists the opportunity to engage with their fans in a live performance setup, direct from our lounge to yours, as we've always liked to say. But we are an independently funded venture. By funded, I'm talking, of course, by Event AV Services, that funds and produces this show, and has done a terrific job over the past 5 months, but it is no longer financially viable for us to continue. But I do want to take this opportunity to say a massive thank you to everyone who has donated or bought a ticket and attended, or even just like, followed, and shared us on the internet. Everything you guys have done and your words of support and telling your friends about it, without you and your help, we really wouldn't have been able to live this dream for as long as we have thus far. And of course, if there are any would-be sponsors out there,
contact us, please. But in the meantime, please join us for tomorrow night and then next week. As Ryan says, that will be the very last Live in Your Lounge. It'll be just a little bit different. There still will be, of course, a free stream available. But because we are nearing the end, that means you've absolutely got to tune in. My name is Lexi. I have loved the last 5 months, and I know I'm going to love tomorrow night and next week as well.
And my name is Ryan Banks, and for one of the last times I'll be able to say this, from all of us here at Live in Your Lounge, thank you and good night.
Ashes to ashes, we're dust to dust. You mess with my woman, and God, you better try.
Tomorrow night on Live in Your Lounge with a live studio audience, Thunder Fox and Thunder Goose.
Oh, promise me, darling.